if that works.
Thank you.
all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Join me in reading the psalm responsively.
poor.
Deliver them from the power of the wicked.
They do not know, neither do they understand. They go about in darkness.
All the foundations of the earth are shaking.
Now I say to you, you are gods.
And all of your children are most high.
Nevertheless, you shall die like mortals.
And fall like any ruler.
Arise, O God, and rule the earth.
For you shall take all the nations for your own.
A reading from Paul's letter to the Colossians. Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, and Timothy, our brother, to the saints and faithful brothers and sisters in Christ and Colossae. Grace to you and peace from God our Father. In our prayers for you, we always thank God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, for we have heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and of the love you have for all the saints. Because of the hope laid up for you in heaven, you have heard of this hope before in the word of the truth, the gospel that has come to you. Just as it is bearing fruit and growing in the whole world, so it has been bearing fruit among yourselves from the day you heard it and truly comprehended the grace of God. This you learned from Epaphras, our beloved fellow servant. He is a faithful minister of Christ on your behalf, and he has made known to us your love and spirit. For this reason, since the day you heard it, we have not ceased praying for you and asking that you may be filled with the knowledge of God's will in all spiritual wisdom and understanding, so that you may lead lives worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing to him, and as you bear fruit in every good work, as you grow in the knowledge of God, may you be made strong with all the strength that comes from his glorious power, and may you be prepared to endure everything with patience, while joyfully giving thanks to the Father, who has enabled you to share in the inheritance of the saints and the light. He has rescued us from the power of darkness and transferred us into the kingdom of his beloved Son, in whom we have redemption, forgiveness of sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
No, I think I'll do a different one. You know, I'm just going to do this one. Just then a lord stood up to test Jesus. A lawyer stood up to test Jesus. Father, he said, what must I do to inherit eternal life? He said to him, what is written in the law? What do you read there? He answered, you shall love the Lord with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, with all your mind, and your neighbor as yourself. And he said to him, you have given the right answer. Do this and you will live. But wanting to justify himself, he asked Jesus, and who is my neighbor? Jesus replied, a man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho and fell into the hands of robbers, who stripped him, beat him, and went away, leaving him half dead. Now by chance a priest was going down that road, and when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. So likewise a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, while traveling, came near him, and when he saw him, he was moved with pity. He went to him and bandaged his wounds, having poured oil and wine on him. Then he put him on his own animal, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. The next day he took out 2 denarii, gave them to the innkeeper, and said, take care of him, and when I come back, I will repay you whatever more you spend. Which of these three do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of the robber? He said, the one who showed him mercy. Jesus said to him, go and do likewise. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Critically ill back here in Minneapolis. And I was desperate to get here. I drove the 6.5-hour distance, leaving straight from work. And at about 2 o'clock in the morning, I was driving on 35 north of Des Moines near the Minnesota border when my car started to fail. I was able to get off the freeway at an all-night gas station, which was basically deserted. The service bays were shut down. There was still one young guy sitting behind the counter. And I told him my situation. You know, I'm trying to get back to Minneapolis before my father dies. And I didn't have much hope, because he seemed very young. I was 25, and he seemed a lot younger than me. So I wasn't, and I could tell that everything was closed up, so. And he said, well, you know, let me take a look at it. And he opened up the service bay, and brought the car in, and put it up there, and said, you know, I think I know how to fix this. And he said, if you could just kind of run the cash register and pump gas. He said, I think I can maybe fix this car. And it took a while. I mean, it was a couple of hours. And he was just working away on this thing. And I did pump gas and run the cash register. There weren't very many customers. And the thing is that it would have been so easy for him to say, oh, no, I mean, we're all shut down for the night. I'm just a young kid. I couldn't open this place up. I'm sure he was violating every rule in the book as far as his manager was concerned. But he diagnosed the problem. He repaired it, and he got me on my way.
And I was able to be with my father before he died. That gas station attendant was my Good Samaritan that day. I was in trouble at the side of the road, and he patched me up and got me on my way. Throughout my life, I've been so blessed by people who saw my situation, just seemed to figure out what was going on. Even in some circumstances where I didn't understand my situation. And they were able to reach out to help me. And I remember when I was 35, and St. David's rallied around my young family. Holly was 3, Rusty was 6. Well, I spent 2 months in the hospital, very, very ill. And man tells the story often about Randy Lindquist stopping over to the house with an enormous load of kid-friendly groceries. And I'm in the hospital, man's at home with the 2 kids. And these were just foods that kids love to eat so that you could make sure for her, her job was made a little bit easier, you know. The meal planning and making sure that the kids got something to eat while she was so distracted. And there was a case where Randy was another of our Good Samaritans. Our family was in distress at the side of the road. And she stepped in to equip us with what would keep us going for many, many days. And as did so many people here at St. David's. So let's stop and think of the Good Samaritans in our lives who have reached out to help us when we needed it at a certain time in our life. How did they help us to continue on down the road? And just take a moment to think of just one Good Samaritan in your life. Now turn to someone near you or a couple of people who are near you and just share your Good Samaritan story. Just tell what was your situation, who reached out to you, who spotted you, and how did they get you back onto the road and moving on your journey. Okay? So you can be the person sitting next to you, or you can turn around if you want to, and however it works out, find somebody you can share your story.
Totally undeserved, and you know, just out of the goodness of their heart, out of the goodness of their heart, you know, I mean, there was way more than I needed from them, and way more than I needed, you know, to feed them and everything, you know, to be moving again at the hotel. And, you know, they're just so blessed by that. I mean, I was just, and since that, you know, after that, they did this many times. They billed me out many times when I was really short of money for something, whether it was a car or whatever, you know. They've been so good to me through the years. I mean, they just, I don't know about that.
Isn't it a gift?
Right, yeah. Oh, it does. It, no, I know. You know, we've been praying for Colin Mitchell, who is Andy. I'm sorry, that's Andy's sister, his child, is non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, since 18, she's been diagnosed. I mean, he's a priest yet, and I don't know how spiritual he is. I mean, normally I'd send a card that says, I'm praying for you, and blah, blah, blah. I didn't want to do that for this young kid, so I conjured up, I know the Holy Spirit gave this to me. I sent him a lot of
stuff.
I ended up sending him a
tell a story.
Fields cookies. And that just, you talk about feeling good to give. That just felt so good.
Okay, we're not done yet.
We're not done.
Now, turn back to that same person or people that you just met with and say to them, go and do likewise.
Go and do likewise.
Go and do likewise. Yes. Oh, no, I don't. I know not nearly enough. But yes, I'm just making a mess.
Amen.
And I know you guys both do it.
Right.
I mean, just think about what you do every year at Christmas time for all those people at the
but,
you know,
just makes it.
Yeah, I don't know what you do. Mm-hmm.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken to the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
With all our heart and with all our mind, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, have mercy.
For the peaceful love, the loving kindness of God, for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the world, for the welfare of the Holy Church of God, and for the unity of all peoples, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Bishop Curry and Bishop Loya, and for all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our president, for the leaders of the nations, and for all in authority, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For seasonable weather and for an abundance of the fruits of the earth, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the good earth which God has given us, and for the wisdom and will to conserve it, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who travel us, O Lord, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
In the communion of David and all the saints, let us commend ourselves, Lord, together, and all our life to Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord, our God.
O Lord, our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people and the multitude of your mercies. Look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace. Peace, peace, peace. Peace, peace, peace. Peace, 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 peace. Peace, peace. Peace, peace.
I'd like to get everybody a picture.
Peace.
Thank you.
up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We praise you and we bless you, holy and gracious God, source of life abundant. From before time you made ready the creation. Your spirit moved over the deep and brought all things into being. Sun, moon, and stars, earth, winds, and waters, and every living thing. You made us in your image and taught us to walk in your ways. But we rebelled against you and wandered far away. And yet as a mother cares for her children, you would not forget us. Time and again you called us to live in the fullness of your love. And so this day, we join with saints and angels in a chorus of praise that rings through eternity, lifting our voices to magnify you as we sing. Let us pray. Loving God, we give you thanks for restoring us in your image and nourishing us with spiritual food in the sacrament of Christ's body and blood. Now set us forth a people forgiven, healed, renewed, that we may proclaim your love to the world and continue in the risen life of Christ our Savior. Amen. Life is short and we do not have much time to gladden the hearts of those who travel with us along the way. So make haste to love, be quick to be kind, and the God of compassion will go with you. The blessing of God Almighty, Creator, Redeemer, and Sanctifier be with you this day and remain with you forever.
And then also tonight, for anyone interested, A bunch of us in St. David's are involved in a musical ecumenical evening prayer service that's happening in the chapel at University of St. Catherine. And it's just gorgeous, meditative, contemplative music with a fabulous choir. There's also a Zoom link. Email me if you want that. Thank you.
David Harrison, and once again, we're selling tickets outside for a raffle, which we call a benefit. It'll be for our outreach program. It'll be outside, so thank you.
So we got donuts today from a baker's wife, which is probably in our top three. But if you want to know the best donut shop in the Twin Cities, you'll have to wish Allie a happy birthday and ask her. And the second reason to come down is that today is actually Catherine's birthday. Yeah. So we're celebrating Catherine, so make sure you wish Catherine a happy birthday.
Thanks, my dad.
Thank you.
Baker's Lake, okay. Finish.